Good evening, you're watching the Daily News Bulletin. I'm Navya Singh. Let's begin with the headlines today. Let's first begin with the COVID-19 updates. India's coronavirus tally has surged past the 72 lakh mark after the country added over 63,000 fresh infections in the last 24 hours. Talking about the deaths due to the deadly virus, over 700 people lost their lives in the last 24 hours due to COVID-19 in India. In a good news, over 63 lakh people have already recovered of COVID-19 in the country. Union Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan has said that India might have a vaccine against coronavirus by early next year, and the vaccine could come from more than one source. Shifting focus to Gujarat, the Gujarat police has denied reports of any attacks on a Tanishq store in the state. Now, several reports were emerging all throughout the day that claimed that there was an attack on a Tanishq store in Gujarat on 12th of October following incessant and endless trolling of the brand that recently pushed out an advertisement promoting interfaith marriages and religious harmony. Now, the police has said that no such attack has taken place in the state. The police has also clarified that two people came to Tanishq store in Gandhidham in Gujarat and demanded to put up an apology in Gujarati. The police has mentioned that the shop owner had fulfilled the demand, but he was getting threat calls. The news about the store being attacked is completely false, according to the Gujarat police. In another major news, a 23-year-old law student in Uttar Pradesh who had accused former BJP MP Chinmay Anand of rape back in 2019 turned hostile and did not accept any of the allegations that she had made against the former BJP MP back in 2019. Remember, ladies and gentlemen, Chinmay Anand was arrested in 2019 on charges of rape and was released in February early this year. Shifting focus to the economy, the International Monetary Fund in its recent report has mentioned that India is all set to drop below Bangladesh in terms of per capita GDP or the per capita growth. The IMF in its report has mentioned that Indian economy is likely to contract by 10.3% this year. However, what's hopeful is that the IMF has also predicted that the Indian economy is likely to bounce back with a massive 8.8% growth rate in 2021. Shifting focus to the environment, the Central Pollution Control Board has issued a show cause notice to Patanjali and Flipkart in connection with the violation of Plastic Waste Management Rules 2018. Now, this action by the Pollution Control Board comes in response to a petition filed by a 16-year-old man identified as Aditya Dubey against Amazon and Flipkart for using excessive plastic packaging. Meanwhile, the National Green Tribunal has ordered the Pollution Control Board body to take action against the firms and also recover compensation for violation of environment norms. That's all for today. I'll be back with some more important news tomorrow. Thanks for watching.